Our phone lines just lit up last night with anxious viewers reporting they'd felt an earthquake.
As WREG's Jessica Gertler reports, a magnitude 4.0 quake with an epicenter near Poplar Bluff, Missouri, is a reminder of how active the New Madrid seismic zone is.
I was just in my hotel room and I just felt a little bit of a shake and I wondered.
This woman is visiting Memphis from Idaho and was startled by Wednesday night's earthquake.
Because I had experienced an earthquake about a year ago in Idaho, and it was really a little eerie.
We record about 400 earthquakes per year in the New Madrid seismic zone.
Gary Patterson is director of the Center for Earthquake Research and Information at the U of M. He showed us the graph of Wednesday night's quake recorded at Siri in East Memphis.
The first wave is the primary wave. It's like a sound wave, but it doesn't do any damage. The damaging wave is the secondary wave that can be seen here, and you can see the amplitude of the wave is much higher.
He says a 4.0 quake can crack plaster and shake objects off shelves, but no damage has been reported in Memphis. He says not everyone in Memphis felt the quake unless you were still or at rest when it hit. But a look at this Did You Feel It map shows how many reports were filed and how large an area was affected.
Stretching down from Memphis all the way up into St. Louis. So this is an area of over 90,000 square miles.
Patterson says new broadband technology at Siri's offices has long since replaced the old drum-type needle graph and can more accurately pinpoint a quake's location and magnitude. But public awareness and preparedness is key.
An earthquake, unfortunately, occurs without warning. It's not like a weather event.
Jessica Gertler, WAG News Channel 3.
An aftershock deployment team could be traveling to Poplar Bluff in the next few days to set out instruments and learn more about the earthquake there.